Have you ever wondered why the price of oil never stays the same? If you take a look at the price of oil over the past few years, you will notice that it's always changing. For example, in April 2020, the price of oil dropped all the way down to zero, while now it's at about $100 per barrel. If you're not familiar with barrels, it's just a unit of measurement used for selling oil. One barrel is equivalent to approximately 42 gallons or 159 liters. So what are the main reasons for such big fluctuations in oil prices? As you probably already know, the price of almost any product depends on supply and demand, and oil is no different. However, to really understand how supply and demand affect the oil prices, we need to take a closer look. So what are the main factors affecting the price of oil? The first one is production cost. One of the first factors affecting the price of oil is how much it actually costs to get the oil out of the ground. As technology and production efficiencies are improving, the cost of getting oil out of the ground are also decreasing. One example of technological transformation that allowed companies to produce more oil at a lower price is hydraulic fracturing. If you're not familiar with hydraulic fracturing, it's just a process of injecting a mixture of water, sand, and chemicals into the wall to create fractures in low permeability formations, such as shale, and allow hydrocarbons to flow more easily towards the wellbore. The second factor affecting the price of oil are the transportation costs. The price of oil also highly depends on where the oil is located and how easy it is to get to the consumer. In locations with a lack of pipelines or any other ways to efficiently move it, the price of oil is usually lower. One good example is the Canadian oil, which is often experiencing the pipeline capacity issues and is usually sold at a discount in comparison to WTI or Brent. Next factor affecting the price of oil is the type of oil. Usually light oil will be sold at a premium in comparison to heavier oil. Oil density is usually measured using API gravity, and the light oil has a higher API gravity than heavy oil. For example, both Brent and WTI have API gravity of about 40, while Western Canadian Select has gravity of 20. Here's the equation which can be used to calculate the API gravity of crude oil. The reason why light oil is priced higher is because you can make more gasoline and diesel from lighter oil than from heavy oil. Another factor that affects the oil price is whether the oil is sweet or sour. Sour oil contains sulfur and it's sold at a discount because it's more expensive to refine than sweet oil. Another important factor that affects the price of oil is demand. Demand for oil varies from country to country. Usually first world countries use much more oil than developing countries. The amount of oil used also depends on the weather. During cold winters and hot summers, more oil is used because to warm up the houses or to cool them down. The state of the economy also plays a role in the price of oil. When the economy is booming, the oil prices go up because industry needs more oil to stay busy, and when the economy is experiencing the recession, the price of oil go down because there is lower demand for it. It's likely that in the future, renewable energy will help to significantly decrease our reliance on crude oil, but for now, this renewable industry doesn't have much effect on the prices of oil. The next factor that affects the price of oil is the supply. When there is more oil produced and consumed, the price of oil obviously drops. That's what happened in April 2020, when there was so much oil available that there was not enough space to store it, and that's why the prices dropped below zero. Geopolitics can also affect the price of oil because it can affect the oil supply. For example, if there is a conflict in an oil-producing country, or there is a fear that the conflict might affect oil supply because of the damage to oil infrastructure such as pipelines or tankers, prices can go up pretty fast. You can usually see these spikes whenever there is some type of conflict in the Middle East. Organizations like OPEC can also affect the price of oil by artificially decreasing the supply of it to lift the prices like it was done in 2018. OPEC is basically a union of oil producing countries that controls about 40% of the world's oil supply. To affect oil prices, OPEC usually sets production quotas for its member countries in order to decrease or increase oil supply. Natural disasters can also have effect on the oil supply by affecting oil production. For example, if there is a strong hurricane in the Gulf of Mexico, it might temporarily decrease oil supply and increase oil prices. Lastly, developments in technology can also significantly increase the oil supply. One example that we already discussed is the hydraulic fracturing, which helped to significantly increase the oil production from the oil fields that were not economical before. And lastly, we have our market speculations. Similar to the rest of commodities, oil is affected by speculations in the market. Fears and rumors can drive the price of oil in both directions.